Hey everybody, my name is Philip and welcome back to another episode of SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated. Oh. In the last episode we finished up mostly what we can do in Cool Lagoon. And now we're heading to the Poseidon.
I have brought you two here to face a great challenge.
I've got nerves of steel and muscles of sand.
And eyes of jelly.
My Poseidon has been breached by a mighty foe whom you must vanquish.
Bring it on, Your Highness. Bring it on.
In this corner, defending the Poseidon, a small square guy. And his challenge. A huge murderous robot shaped like a squirrel.
Look, it's a giraffe.
I think I need to get home to feed Gary.
Alright, so right now we have to battle against a gigantic sandy robot. Let's see, oh god, it's kind of different. She looks scary. Actually, like, this is a cool new design.
Now the robot's taking a beating out there.
Also, like this,
oh,
this team stack. That's her tail is awesome.
Opening, but will he get the drop on the robot?
All right, and after 3 hits, the scoreboard goes down. Alright, so we're now being Patrick. He wants to join in. Now, I believe they made Sandy smaller.
The old clothesline move.
At least she doesn't feel as gigantic as she used to. So well, we just have to pick up the head after it falls off and throw it into the scoreboard. Which also hurts the body for some reason. I'm not really sure how that works, but it works. But like, oh yeah, the icon in the bottom left is cooler. Like, yeah, I like this.
Looks like Patrick has
all right.
Here.
So yeah, that's changed quite a lot. Like. But I welcome this change, like this cool design. We have more SpongeBob memes in the back there. Let's see, what's that? Oh, it's Sandy! Oh, that's cool. Oh yeah, from the episode where she has a hibernation.
The robot's losing its head!
Alright, let's grab the head. Come on, come. It's rolling away. No, gimme.
Wow, I've never seen such an electrifying match!
Your turn, SpongeBob!
Oh?
Wee. Like they, I don't remember what was on the original, like banners. I mean, there were still banners, but I don't quite remember what. Why do a single jump over there? Or, you know, fail it. Whatever works. Alright, so now we have to do the bash attack. Don't get too close, you'll do a karate chop. Alright, I need to get the timing of that, but it shouldn't matter too much. Crap. Alright, now it might matter. Oh, feck. Yeah, I might die actually. What am I not doing right at the timing?
There's the robot's vulnerability. Let's see.
Maybe if
SpongeBob
I double jump, that
it.
Might do it.
Nice move by SpongeBob.
No.
This match
Feck.
Is just about over. Ow.
Alright, then let's try this again. We do get a checkpoint after, I guess, every phase. Which yeah, you need to double jump. Alright, I guess that's what I was doing wrong. I don't remember if there were checkpoints in the original. Most likely they were not. Because honestly, games back then were a bit more difficult. Yeah, it's weird that you have to double jump. Because that means that the bottom part of the attack is, I mean the top part of the attack is just useless. Oh, but oh wait, now it doesn't really matter. Just grab some underwear. Alright then, here we go. Robot Sandy is defeated.
That was quite a battle. Tell him what he's won, Johnny.
It's a new power, the Bubble Bowl. But wait, there's more. A golden spatula, and that's not all. A gift certificate for $5.32 to Dean's Little Shop of Dried Fish Flakes and Flowers.
Oh, thank you. It all means so much. I promised myself I wouldn't cry.
Cry all you want, but not here. We just wax the floors.
Hey, Plankton.
Yes, what is it?
I was just wondering why all the robots seem to be coming from inside the chum bucket.
Have they? I really haven't noticed.
Yeah. And then there's that big flashing neon sign that says, Robot Headquarters.
Oh, that's a bit suspicious.
SpongeBob, I'm your friend, right?
That's debatable.
No, not really.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Exactly, and as your non-friend, I worry about you. Like right now, you're thinking too much. I'm worried you might really hurt yourself. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna think for you. This way you won't hurt yourself, and you can just keep working on getting me into the chum bucket.
Thanks, Plankton. You're the best non-friend a friend could have. No more thinking for me.
Right. Well, alright then. I guess that's settled. We don't have to think about anything anymore. That's great.
You had a bowl of bubble. Press this button and you'll bowl a bubble that can knock down robots from a safe distance.
Wow!
Remember though, the bubble bowl only works on things that are close to the ground.
Got it.
So yeah, we got a new power up, which is the bubble bowl. Which I will demonstrate right here. It's a bowling ball. In the form of a bubble. Simple as that. We also now have access to this, which we can roll around in. Doesn't really do anything, I guess it's just a fast way to travel. Because like the map has expanded. But yeah. First off, I want to see the official names of all of the robots we have encountered so far.
It shines.
And we can do that right over here. In the police station. Alright, let's see. Alright, it's a bit dark, but I guess that's fitting. We have this gigantic, I guess not that giant, but a pretty big computer. Which we can check on all of the robots we have seen so far. We can also have a little previews of the other ones. No, I hate fucking these ones. So, oh, these ones are horrible as well. But that's for later. Let's check the names. Father. Because they're father enemy. Nifty Electrical Tough Attack. Not tall enough to ride most roller coasters, but more vicious than a pack of rabbit clams. G-Love. Oh, I was close with Slappy Hands. Has the most vicious smack attack. Hands down. Expert foot masseurs. Lemon squeezer. And does delightful hand puppet shows. Huh. Chuck. Annoying missile attack. Likes to throw tantrums. And other various military grade ordnance. Not terribly friendly. Fucking Chucks. Hammer. Hey, I was close on this one. Impressive meat byproduct attack. Except they changed it to metal. Oh well. Smarter than it looks? goes well with broccoli and a nice Chianti. Again, they changed it to metal, so it doesn't really work anymore. Monsoon. Shocking electrical attack. Rather sensitive. Reads poetry. Likes plants and enjoys sapping wandering denizens. Tartar. I was actually close to this one, right? Uncanny flying tartar sauce attack. Smells somewhat better than steel fish. Alright. The chomp bot. Somewhat unstable critter, beware. His stinky doggy breath. Likes to chew toys, random citizens, and mimes. And we have Plankton. Plankton is the finest model citizen, I know. He likes helping people, singing, hacking computers. Never mind that last bit. Plankton's the best. Alright, I think Plankton might have written these. This is the robot viewer. Step on the metal squirm in front of the viewer to activate it. You can use the viewer to read the case files of captured robots. And Plankton, I guess. But I guess Plankton wrote all of these. Hello, sir. You seem to have a lot of paperwork just everywhere lying around. I guess I won't disturb you then. So that's all you can do in here. For the rest, there's nothing to do. Alright, so what will the next stop be? Let's see, let's do this actually. Alright, so we just have to stand on this platform and then roll a ball into it. That will make platforms appear. We can then use this to jump on top. I mean, if I could do a bit of platforming, that would be great. I could move over, thank you. Hurry up. Alright, I might have to do it again. Oh well. Just gonna wait a bit. There we go. There's also some golden underpants over there, but we'll get to it later. First I wanna do this time thingy. Ooh, that was close. I just keep jumping. Excuse me. Fucking hell. That's a tough jump, actually. Let's try that again.
Bolo-rama.
Come on, but where's the button? Don't miss it, SpongeBob. Thank you. Alright, jump on top. Jump over here. I do want to get that golden spatula today. Like, Mac, they don't even give you time to react. Come on, yeah. Oh, just about. I know, I feel like they messed up the timing with that. Like the developers, like... It shouldn't be that quick. Oh well. I still made it. So that's something at least. Now let's press it again. So we can get this. Oh, I can win the bell. Now let's see. Well, we have Sandy's dome over here. Let's pay her a visit.
Sandy, your tree dome is leaking!
Them there robots busted up the glass, SpongeBob! I got a treehouse chock full of robots and it's all your fault, so get in there and clean up your mess!
Alright, so yeah, there are robots everywhere in Sandy's dome. They cracked up the glass. Oh, we have the bomb robots now. Crap. Right, it's not going well right now, but
I feel like a new sponge.
Just keep destroying them. Alright, destroy all of the duplicatrons and you should be fine. Just keep avoiding the Tartar. Alright, that's not really avoiding it.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Right. We are also like totally dried up, which is cool.
Alrighty then, that's much better. I suppose you'll be needing this more than me.
And from defeating all of the robots, we get a really creepy close-up of SpongeBob's face. God, that's horrifying actually. We also get a golden spatula. Alright, that's it. Leaving now. Alright then, so... I mean, Mr. Krabs is there. He has nothing new to say. He's just going to be more... wrong button, sorry. I just want to check my totals. He's just going to like offer the skull and spatulas for the shinies we have collected. Not that great. We can have a little sneak peek in the next area, which contains the Krusty Krab. Well, some scary looking thing. That over there is the cinema, the jump bucket. And back there we can see the kelp forest. Also the little circle on the ground is something different. It's actually a really fun world to explore. But we'll get to it later. Right now...
Nothing like the smell of bubbles in the morning.
I think we're going to enter in this, the Shady Shoals Rest Home.
Man and Barnacle Boy, my heroes! Hit me with a water ball, hit me!
We don't do that stuff anymore, kid. We're retired.
Is that the TV repairman?
No, it's that excited sponge kid again.
Are you sure he can't fix the TV?
Mermaid Man, 'twould be my greatest honor to fix your television.
Could be!
Hey, sponge kid, you really want to help out?
NPC, if you're talking over here.
Oh boy, would I?
Okay then, but lighten up a bit on the enthusiasm, huh? You're making my bowels act up. We've got a little problem with some robots down in the Mermalair. Are you sure you're up to this task?
Absolutely, Barnacle Boy!
Well, go over to the couch to access the Mermalair. We'll meet you-
Is it pudding night yet?
So yeah, we got a quest form. Barnacle Boy and Mermaid Man. Which is actually quite exciting. We get to help SpongeBob's heroes. Again. Now let's see, if I remember correctly. Yes, by just spinning around in a bit, destroying everything. We get another sock.
Another find for Patrick!
Ah, just 1 minute ago. We can also attack the handicapped. That's fun. But let's talk to Mermaid Man. So we can enter the Mermaid Lair. And there we go, right down the hatch. So we have arrived. Let's see, nothing back there. We can enter right here to get back home. And yeah. Oh, this looks great actually. I like the lighting. Let's destroy you. Activate you. And move away. Boom.
Evil!
Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy.
Well, he's pretty, energetic for an old guy.
You shouldn't sneak up on Mermaid Man like that. His heart's not so good. Come to think of it, nothing on him is that good anymore.
Sorry, Mermaid Man. It's just that I'm always so excited to see you two. Standing in your awesome presence gives me the chills of justice. See? I've got goosebumps on my goosebumps on my goosebumps on my goosebumps on my...
All right, kid. Knock it off. Just tell us what you want.
Well, I really want a new pair of sunglasses. Patrick sat on my old ones.
That's not what I meant.
Actually, it's a good thing you showed up, young sponge of goodness.
It is?
It is?
Yes, a bunch of evil robots have taken over the Mermalair security system. It's up to you to shut it down and stop them.
But why him? We're perfectly capable superheroes.
Because it's Thursday and we have a whole bunch of doctor's appointments.
Fish sticks. I forgot.
Go talk to the Mermalair computer in the next room. She'll tell you what to do.
I accept this awesome responsibility, Mermaid Man. You won't be disappointed. Shamed, maybe, but not disappointed.
Well, then.
To the doctor's office! Away!
And then they just stand there. Great. So yeah, Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy are probably one of my favorite characters from the show. Just the idea of like retired superheroes. Like, it's really funny. You can also assault them. Respect your elders and stuff. But yeah. In the next episode, we're going to talk to their computer. See what's the problem really is. And we'll explore the Mermaid Lair. Which, I mean, who knew that under a rest house there's just a massive, gigantic cave. But oh well. See you guys then. Goodbye.